Luke, the 16th chapter, verse number 19 and 21. Let's say 22. Hey, glory to God. Father God, bless this person that's watching this video. Oh God, let it be a new transpiration. Oh God, let them know that there's a hell that's waiting, but I'm not going there. Bless the hearer right now. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. Luke, the 16th chapter, verse 19. And it read, there was a certain rich man, which was clothed in purple and fine linen, and fared sumptuously every day. And there was a certain beggar named Lazarus, which was laid at his gate full of sores, and desired to be fed with crumbs which fell from the rich man's table. Moreover, the dog came and licked his sore, and it came to pass that the beggar died, and was carried by angel into Abraham's bosom. And the rich man also died, and was buried. And in hell he lifted up his eyes, being in torment, and seeing Father Abraham and Lazarus in his bosom, and he cried and said, Father Abraham, have mercy on me, and send Lazarus that he may dip the tip of his finger in water and cool my tongue, for I am in torment in this plain. But Father Abraham said, Son, remember that thou in thy lifestyle receiveth thy good thing, and Lazarus evil thing. But now he's comforted, and thou art tormented. And beside all this, between us and you, there's a great gulf fixed, so that they which would pass from hence to you cannot, neither they shall pass to us that would come from hence. Then he said, I pray thee, therefore, Father, that thou wouldest send me to my father's house, for I have five brethren, that he may testify unto them, lest they also come this place of torment. Father Abraham said, hallelujah, unto him, they have Moses and the prophet, let them hear them. And he said, nay, Father Abraham, but if one went unto them from the dead, they will repent. And he said unto him, if they hear not Moses and the prophet, neither were they persuaded, though one rose from the dead. I read Luke, the 16th chapter, verse 19 and 31. Now the rich man was praying, but it was an unanswered prayer. He said, Father Abraham, I pray thee. Now, while he was on earth, he didn't pray. But while in hell, he was praying. My subject today, hey, glory to God. And don't forget to get my book, hey, glory to God. A place called hell and a lake of fire. Why go to hell? Yes, why go to hell? Because the reason why I say why go to hell, because if you die right now, you're going to hell. Because you play around with your soul salvation. You play around with your soul. And you play around with salvation. You've been going to church all this time and you're still sexing. You go to church all this time and you're still whoring. You go to church all this time and you go to strip club with dollar bills in your pocket. You've been going to church all this time and you are married and you're still cheating on your spouse. All this time and you're bisexual and you're a lesbian. Glory to God, you're a transgender. My friend, all this time. So my subject is, why go to hell? Hey, glory to God. Now I'm going to tell you, hey, there's 10 P's. Hallelujah, of why I go to hell. No party in hell. No pretty girls in hell. No playground in hell. No purchasing whores in hell. We did enough on earth. No pole dancing or hallelujah on in hell. There'll be weeping and gnashing of teeth in hell. More problems and not no hospital or doctor to help you anymore. No peeping being married. No sex in hell. You be burning continually. No more sexual song to turn you on and to call your friend, say that I'm hot, come have sex with me. No sex in hell. No more pretending you are saved in hell. You will be getting out of hell. And the reason why I bring this message, because why go to hell? Now, come on now. Why go to hell? Because you have an opportunity right now to give your life to Jesus Christ. You might not make it for another hour. So the best thing to do right now is decide to say, from this day forth, I'm going to give my life. I'm going to give my love. I'm going to let God lives in me. How do you let God lives in you? Acts 2:38. Hey, glory to God. You must remember that you got to repent, and God will cancel your sin, and you shall receive in the name of Jesus Christ. You can get baptized and you will receive the Holy Ghost, which is your keeper. Why people don't want the Holy Ghost? Because the Holy Ghost is your convictor. But Paul say, my conscience bear witness of the Holy Ghost. So if you have the Holy Ghost, it will stop you from having sex when you're single. It will stop you from cheating if you're married. It will stop you from text sexing on your phone or listen to pornography. So people don't want the Holy Ghost. They want a ghost, but they don't want to be holy. So why go to hell? Make up your mind today. From this day forth, I'm tired of sin. Hey, glory to God. I'm tired of it, because I make up my mind. I'm not going to call him no more. I'm not going to call her no more. I'm not going to strip club no more, because I believe hell is real. So we read Luke, the 16th chapter, verse 19 and 31. This rich man, he went to hell. And when he went to hell, a lot of people say this is a parable, but this is a story that actually happened, because a rich man was praying for somebody to go up and warn his five brethren to don't come to this place called hell. So in hell, you got memory. In hell, you can talk. In hell, you can compromise. In hell now, you got the nerve to say, Father Abraham, send somebody up there to warn my brethren. So I'm telling you right now, that there's a place called hell. And if you're not prepared to be baptized, to have the Holy Ghost, you are going to hell. So the best thing to do, my friend, is make up your mind to say, I'm not going to hell. Why go to hell? Because you are ignorant. You have no insight. You think you're intelligent, but you're not intelligent. You are ignorant. The Bible says, Hosea 4:6, you say, my people are destroyed for lack of knowledge. You think you're intelligent, but you have no insight, but you're ignorant. So the best thing to do, my friend, is make up your mind and say, Father, hallelujah, forgive me. Say, Father, oh Father, forgive me, because I have sinned and I want to get to heaven. I don't want to go to hell, because hell is real. My church not preaching it, the pastor not preaching it, the bishop so much in the money, he's not preaching it. So this prophet is telling you, it's time for you not to go to hell, because hell is a real place. Let me pray for you. Can I pray for you? Can I pray for you? And this prayer will make you determine if you are serious about hell and serious about heaven. Because hell I'm not going, but heaven I am going. So Father God, in the name of Jesus Christ, oh God, Father, forgive me, because I have sinned against thee. Oh Father, let me find a church so I can be baptized in the wonderful name of Jesus Christ. Oh God, and fill me with the Holy Ghost so I can stop sexing. So I can stop watching pornography. I can stop going to strip club. I can stop going to club on Saturday and go to church on Sunday and being a hypocrite. Oh Father God, help me to be the soldier. Help me to be saved. Help me to receive the gift of the Holy Ghost, oh God. Oh God, Father, give me the Holy Ghost to keep me from falling. Bless right now. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. If you say this prayer, I want to find you a church that preaching hell and preaching heaven, not about money, but about your soul salvation. Hey, glory to God.